Good morning, children. Happy to be with you again. I am sure you watched the previous online lessons. I hope you understood everything, the previous chapter. Okay. Today, let's study second chapter of social science. The title of this chapter, From Stone to Metal. Okay. In the previous class, we have already discussed about history, historic period, why the historical monuments are preserving, the importance of historical monuments, then how to reckoning time, what are the different eras also. Okay. In this chapter, From Stone to Metal, we can study about the early life of humans. Okay. Can you imagine the life without home? No school, no another transportation ways. You imagine that so difficult. In this chapter, we can study about that type of a period, the early life of humans. Okay, they were lived in forest, the forest full of wild animals. You know that how they scare away from these animals. We can study from this chapter. Let's watch this video.
The early men. All of us would be aware that the early men roamed the earth around 2 million years ago, who are now referred to as hunter-gatherers. They owe their name to their ways of hunting for food. They usually hunted wild animals, gathered fruits, vegetables, roots and leaves.
From this video, we could understand the life. Information we could get information about their life, how they were lived, what they are doing. Okay, in your textbook, page number 8, open. Then all of you please observe this picture. In this picture, we can see a group of people. What they were doing? They were attacking an animal. For what purpose they were attacking these animals? What type of tools they were used to attack these animals? Please look at this picture. What can you identify from this picture? The life of early human life, human being. We know that. The early human beings lived in forest. The early man being lived in forest. Then they were lived in groups. They hunted animals with rough stones. And they used stems also for hunting. They wore animal skin and leaves. Okay. From this picture, we got a clear picture of early man. The early man lived in forest. They are attacking animals, they hunted hunting animals with rough stones. Then they wore animal skin and the leaves of trees also. Okay. In this picture, you can see the man using stones as their tools. Okay. This period is called Stone Age. When the early man used stones as tools, that period is called Stone Age. We can study different part of this Stone Age in this chapter. Period in which the early man used stones as tools. That period is called the Stone Age. Then Paleolithic Age, Neolithic Age, Chalcolithic Age, then Bronze Age. These are the different stone ages we can study in this chapter. First, Paleolithic Age. Paleolithic Age means Old Stone Age. What do you mean by Old Stone Age? When the early man used rough stones as tools, that period is called Paleolithic Age. In this Paleolithic Age, early man used rough stones. For what purpose they were using these stones? To attacking animals, to hunting animals. Okay. This period is called Paleolithic period. Okay. For what purpose the early man used stones? There is one activity in your textbook like that. For what purpose the early man used stones? First, they used the stones to hunt animals. To hunt animals. Then, to dig up tubers from soil. From soil to dig up tubers, they used these stones. Okay. First, to attacking animals, to hunting animals, then to dig up tubers from soil, they were used these stones. Okay. What are the uses of stones in that time? Okay. Understand what I say? Okay. Then next, please listen this picture. In this picture, you can see different stones. These stones used in Paleolithic period. Please observe this. For what purpose fire might have been used? For what purpose fire must have been used? Here you can see early man. What they were doing? They were cooking food. 100 animals meat they were cooking. Okay. In this picture we can see this group of men cooking food. So they used fire for cooking food. Then scare away from animals. First, for cooking food, scare away from animals to provide light to resist from cold. To cooking food, scare away from animals to provide light to resist from cold. For what purpose fire might have been used? Then what are the uses of stones? The early man, for what purpose fire might have been used and what are the uses of stones also study. Then, when they are using these rough stones, they could understand that with sharp stones, very easily they could slice the 100 animals' meat. Otherwise, they understand that to dig up tubers, that is very easy with the sharp stones. the period in which the early man used sharpened and polished tools. That period is called Neolithic period, Neolithic age. In this Paleolithic period, the early man used rough stones. But in Neolithic period, what type of tools they used? They used stones. What type of stones they were used? Sharpened and polished stones as tools. Okay, difference. In Paleolithic age, they used rough stones. But in Neolithic age, they used sharpened and polished tools. Okay, now let's observe that picture. Your textbook, page number 25, you can see a picture. In this picture, you can see in Neolithic period, the lifestyle of the human life in the Neolithic period. Okay. What can you understand from this picture? In this picture, you can see they engaged in farming. Okay. They make shelters. Okay. Then you can see they made making pots. Then wheels pictures also you can see here. In this time they used wheels. Okay. When Paleolithic period they eat flesh meat. Okay, flesh, not cooked. But in this period they began to eat cooked food. And you can see they wear dress also. Okay. From this picture, the human life in the Neolithic age, we know that they engaged in farming, developed shelters, they made pots, used wheels, began to eat cooked food, then they wear dresses. Okay? Differentiate between Paleolithic period and Neolithic period. What are the differences we can see in Paleolithic period and Neolithic period? Here we can see difference in this field. Okay? First, tools. In Paleolithic period, they were used rough stones. In Paleolithic period, the early man used rough stones. But in Neolithic period, they used sharpened and polished tools. First difference, Paleolithic period they used rough stones, then Neolithic period they used sharpened and polished tools. Okay, first difference. Then cloth, there is also difference. Okay, they began to wear cloth in this Neolithic period. Then Paleolithic period they used animal skin and leaves as the dress. Okay. Tools, cloth, then shelter. In Paleolithic period, they lived in trees, otherwise caves. Okay, but in Neolithic period, they began to make shelter, otherwise homes. Okay, understand? Tools, cloth, shelter. Then agriculture. In this Paleolithic period, they don't know about agriculture. They wandered throughout this forest and hunting animals, that type of a life. But in Neolithic period, they began to settle the life and began agriculture. Okay? In this about agriculture, Paleolithic period, they don't know about agriculture. The Neolithic period, they began agriculture. Then social life. In Paleolithic period, they lived in groups. Okay? The first picture you can see a group of men attacking one animal. Okay, they began how they lived? They lived in groups. But in Neolithic period they began agriculture, so they began to live near their field, making house, then started social life. These are the difference between Paleolithic period and Neolithic period. Chalcolithic period. In this Chalcolithic period, they used copper tools, then stone tools also. copper tools and stone tools. Okay. In this Neolithic period, when they are using these rough, sharpest tools, at that time they invented metal, copper. Then they could understand that with the use of this metal, very easily they could dig up tubers and attacking animals. Then they use this copper tools. This period, copper plus stone tools using, that period is called Chalcolithic period. In this Chalcolithic period, they used copper and stone tools. Paleolithic period, Neolithic period, then Chalcolithic period. Paleolithic period, rough stones. Neolithic period, sharpened and polished stones. Then Chalcolithic period, copper plus stone. Okay. Then last, Bronze Age. In this Bronze Age, they invented another metal, a mixture of copper and tin. That is harder than other metals. You understand that copper plus tin, that is called bronze. That metal is very harder. Then to mold it, that is also very easy. So they use this copper plus mixture of copper and tin, that means bronze. That period is called, that age is called Bronze Age. Okay. In your textbook, there is one activity, the complete a flowchart. All of you open that. What changes might have been brought about by improvement in agriculture? In this Bronze period, Bronze Age, you know that they used this bronze tools, bronze metal as tools. Then they began agriculture. So they could do agriculture easily because they used these tools. Then there we can see a production of this agricultural product increasing. They use this agricultural product enough. Then the balance of this product, what they do? The surplus of this product they began to store. Okay. Then they began to exchange this balanced food grains, otherwise this food products. Then they find the place to exchange these products, like that formed markets. Okay, for exchanging this product, then began to find one area, one place. Then they exchange their product to others and they purchasing their products. Okay, there is a mutual exchange between in this man. Okay, you understand what I say? They are exchanging their product, then they began to purchase other product. They find one place also for that, markets, like markets. Markets also formed. Okay, there is a mutual exchange of products. Okay. Then they to for increasing this product, they use a new type of agricultural tools also. Okay. Let's observe next picture. Different occupational field. You can see a picture of different occupational field developing in that time. Okay. What can you see in this picture? Here we can see pot making. Pot making. Then pot making. Then what is that? Other picture you can see different metals, using metals, ornaments are making. Different tools making, construction works, different types of occupational field also began in this time. Okay. Today, in this second chapter, we have learned about Stone Age. Okay, what do you mean by Stone Age? The period in which stones are using as tools, that period is called Stone Age. Then Paleolithic period, Neolithic period, Chalcolithic period, then Bronze Age also. Okay, in Paleolithic period, they used rough stones as tools. Okay. Then Neolithic period, they used the early man used rough, not rough, polished and sharper tools, stones, okay. Then Chalcolithic period, they used copper plus stones, okay. Then Bronze Age, copper plus tin, okay. Based on their tools, the period is differentiated into four, okay. Then you have assignments also. All of you take your notebook and write two assignments. First, for what purpose fire might have been used by early man? First question, for what purpose fire might have been used by early man? Then second question, in what ways does the Neolithic age differ from the Paleolithic period? In what ways does the Neolithic age differ from Paleolithic period? That means difference between Paleolithic period and Neolithic period. Okay. Thank you.